This is Dr. Femiani. I just want to do a quick reply to a discussion post in an Ubuntu VM. I'm pressing Control, Alt, and T to open up a terminal. This is about using doc tests in Python, and I'm going to show you what they are and how they work real quickly. I'm going to pull up idle, and I could do it from the terminal, but I'll just do it right here from the Ubuntu menus. So this is idle, and this is the Python interpreter, and then these are the chevron, the Python prompt. And if I do file, new file, I have a source code. So what we're going to do is maybe make a function that prints "Hello World," right? So the output should be "Hello World." If I say def "Hello World," no parameters, it should print, and we're in two set Python 2.7, "Hello World," just like that. If I run this in a Python shell, F5, save it as sample.py, then I have that function which I can call. There we go, and it prints "Hello World." So this is me testing it in the interactive shell. I'd like to automate that. So what I can do is I can come up here to "Hello World," and I can do something I should do anyway, which is provide documentation for this function. Prints a "Hello World" message as a triple quoted string, which means that it can include multiple lines. And then what I can do is I can pretend that I'm providing some examples on how to use it, and I can just paste in what was in the interpreter, keeping it properly indented. So in the interpreter, if I were to type in "Hello World," then it should print the output "Hello World," just like that. And I'll save that. And from a terminal now, I can actually automatically verify that the examples from the documentation for "Hello World" work. So in order to do that, I type Python dash m to run a module, and the module is called doc test. So doc test is a module that defines a main, a double underscore main function. And when I run it with the input sample.py, which is what I named that, it'll run the tests, and if they all pass, you get no output. But suppose something changes and I mess this up. So here's a wonderful way to mess things up. Those are now ones instead of L's. I love that type of error. And if I save it and I come back here and I try to test it, I run python-m doc test sample.py. It points out that there is a problem. The problem is on line 7. It failed the example called "Hello World," so that's the name of the function it failed. It expected "Hello World" with L's, and it got "Hello World" with ones. So I had one failure. So basically, I mean, that's how this works. If you include the test cases in your comments, it'll automatically run them. This is one way that you can test a module. Another way that you can test a module is you can define, well, you can check to see if you're actually running the module instead of importing it. So you check to see if the name of the module is main. Since this module is called sample.py, you expect the name of it to be called sample. But if you're running it directly from the command line, then it's going to be called main. And if that's the case, then you can do some tests. And I prefer to put those tests in a method, maybe call it main. So here I could test my code, and I can just simply use some assertions. So I could say s equals, well, I could just say, it's a little bit harder to do with something like this because it's supposed to produce output. But suppose I had some function like def square x return x. Come on. Return x squared, right? So I don't need the semicolon. So in main, I could say assert square 2 equals 4. Assert square. What would be maybe a boundary case? 0 equals 0. Assert square 1 equals 1. So those are other kind of ways that you could test this without using dot tests. And if I run this, I can actually print. And run this. And it would actually execute main when I ran it. And since there was no assertion failed, I know that it passed. And if I wanted to, I could produce extra output. This would be another fine way to test it. So you can either test it by defining a driver function in which you actually do the tests, or you can use the dot tests, or you can use both. You could actually import dot tests here, and you could do dot test mod. I think that's what it is. And let's see, I think it returns, well, let's just say 'tests failures' equals that, and print f failures in t tests. I'm not quite sure if that's what test mod returns. You'd have to Google the docs, but I'll just save this and run it. So it automatically it ran the dot test now, and it pointed out the failures, and then it said I had one failure in one tests, and then it proceeded to do these other assertions. So again, this is how you can forcibly run test mod from main in your module, which is okay to do. It won't run any of this if your name is not main. So if I were just to import the module, it wouldn't run that. So again, I think that what you can do with a dot test is usually clearer than using a driver function, but for some things you might want to do a driver function. The important thing is that you test your code. Thank you.